We'll be discussing about hemp fiber, the cultivation, extraction, properties and application of hemp fiber. So hemp is another bast fiber which produces soft in nature, similar to your flax fiber. Okay, so this fiber is obtained from the stalk of the hemp plant. The botanical name is Cannabis stevia. So which is grown extensively in India, not only in India, even China, USSR, Germany, Japan, Turkey, Italy and France. So this fiber is cultivated in these countries like India, China, USSR, Germany, Japan, Turkey, Italy and France. So if you look at the height of the plant is usually grows 2 to 3 meters in height. Then if you look at the thickness of the plant is 1.5 centimeter in thickness. Thickness in the sense the diameter of the plant. Then we will discuss now the cultivation. So a moderate, rich and favorable, well-drained sandy loam is the preferred soil, so which is suitable for the cultivation of this hemp fiber. Then what do you mean by loam? Loam consists of less than 7% clay, less than 50% silt and between 43 and 50% sand. So this is the combination of loam. Loam means it is a consisting of less than 7% clay, less than 50% silt and between 43 and 50% sand. So this is essential for the growth of the hemp plant. Then during the growth of this plant, adequate moisture and 60 mm to 75 mm rainfall per month is needed for the growth of the plant. Okay. So in order to acquire good growth of this plant, what you need adequate moisture content with 60 mm to 75 mm rainfall per month is needed for the growth of the plant. So once this climatic condition is reached, then you start doing the seed is sown in rows with a space of about 12 to 15 centimeter. Between rows and 8 to 10 centimeter between plants. So this is how the seed is sown in the agriculture land. Then stacks are ready for harvesting when the lower leaves just begin to turn yellow color. So when you come to know the fiber or the plant attain its maturity, the leaves are turning or the change in color takes place from green to yellow. So once the color changes takes place, then you will come to know now the plant is ready for harvesting. The duration from sowing to harvesting is about 100 to 120 days. So how much days is needed from the seed sown to the agriculture land to till the harvesting? It needs 100 to 120 days. So at the end of the 120 day, what will happen? The color of the leaves changes from green to yellow. So this indicates the hemp fiber attained its maturity. It is ready for harvesting. Okay. As usual, cutting is done at the particular time when it is judged that the best quality of the fiber will result. Okay, once if you come to know it attained its maturity position, then you can start cutting the plant and it is ready for harvesting. So next we'll discuss the extraction of hemp. So how the fiber has to be extracted. So extraction It is similar to other bast fibers. The method of separating the fibers from the stacks vary widely. So there are four types of rettings are available. These rettings are already we might be discussed during the jute fiber extraction, similar to the flax fiber extraction. Dew retting, stagnant water retting, then running water retting, and then chemical retting. So these are all the four chemical retting processes are available for the extraction of fibers from the plant. Already we might be discussed during the extraction of jute as well as the flax fiber. So dew retting is used in many areas. Why the dew retting is preferred? Because it doesn't need any sort of chemicals, but the duration is little bit longer. Even though the duration of the retting process is little bit longer, but what the people are doing, they are preferring to use dew retting only, because no need of any chemicals. Okay, so no need to maintain any conditions during the process. In other areas, the stacks after being butted and topped or water retted in ponds or tanks or in any other stagnant water. So retting can be done for freshly cut stacks or sun-dried stacks. Okay, so the retting can be done either by means of freshly cutting the stacks directly, you can keep it in the water, or the stacks can be dried under sunlight, then you can do this retting process. However, water for retting should be clean and free from chemical impurities, otherwise the fiber may discolor. So during the retting process, you should be take care the water used for the retting process. It should be very clean. It should not contain any sort of chemicals or impurities. What will happen if impurities or if the water is not clean, then the color of the fiber may changes, takes place. So retting should be properly done in order to obtain better quality of the fiber. Okay. So under retting, the result in rough and broken fiber, and over retting also, what will happen? It will weaken the fiber. So the retting should be done in a proper manner. The retting should not be done in an underestimate. Similarly, the process should not be carried for a prolonged period of time, that is over retting. These two also will cause the fiber damage. So the retting process should be proper in order to obtain better quality of the fiber. So after retting, what you have to do? The stacks are dried by means of methods like hand peeling, then ponding with wooden blocks, pressing in between two wooden blocks, or processing through a breaking machine. The process are similar like that of other bast fibers. So this is how you have to carry out the process after the retting. Okay. Hand peeling, then ponding with wooden blocks, pressing in between two wooden blocks, or processing through a breaking machine. So the process is similar to that of other bast fibers. So already during the last two lectures, I have shown two or three videos. Okay, how the jute fiber is getting extracted, then how the flax fiber is getting extracted. So similarly, the same process has to be carried out for this hemp fiber also. Okay. So now let us see the properties and end use of hemp fiber. So the properties of hemp fiber is similar to that of other bast fibers. Okay. Then you have to refer the properties of jute fiber. Similarly, the properties of the flax fiber. It is similar in properties. So coming to the end use of the hemp fiber, the fiber is quite resistant to weather and moisture. So that is the reason why it is used in the manufacturing of ropes. That is the reason why it is used in the manufacturing of sail and tent cloth. Okay, it is used in household clothing, threads, industrial and marine applications, twines, sacks, bags. Then, to some extent, it is used in the manufacturing of specialty papers. Even it is used as a cigarette paper. And sometimes the same fiber is used as a twine. So these are all the applications of the hemp fiber. So only it has good resistance towards weather and moisture. So based upon this good resistance, it is used for making ropes, sail and tent cloth, household clothing, threads, industrial and marine applications, twines, sacks, bags, specialty papers and cigarette paper and twine. Okay, so these are all the applications of hemp fiber. let us discuss about ramifiber cultivation, extraction, properties and applications. Rami is another bast fiber, you can call it as a stem fiber, obtained from the bark of the plant. The botanical name is displayed in this slide. The plant, the native of the plant is from China, so you can call it as a China grass also. Okay, so the name of the fiber is China grass because it has originated from China. So this plant is also grown in India, Australia, America, Japan, Brazil and Philippines. So the plant requires a tropical climate where winter temperature should be above freezing. Please think it over. The plant requires a tropical climate where winter temperature should be above freezing point. Okay. So the plant grows to a height of 1 to 3 meters with a diameter of approximately 8 to 20 mm in thickness. Then how the rami fiber is cultivating? Rami is a perennial fiber with a yield from 2 to 5 crops of the fiber per year, which depends upon the soil and climatic conditions. It is the longest of all the vegetable fibers. So that is the main advantage of this rami fiber. It is the longest of all vegetable fibers. Rami is ready for harvesting when the lower part of the stalk turns light yellowish brown and the lower leaves matured by turning yellow and detachable. So this indicates the fiber attains its maturity. So when the fiber attains its maturity, the plant stalks turns lightish yellow brown color and the lower leaves matured by turning yellow and detachable. So this indicates the rami fiber attains its maturity. It is ready for harvesting. Now the harvesting is done by cutting the stalks. Okay. So coming to the extraction of rami fiber. So individual rami fiber occurs in the form of bast bundles with ends overlapping and connected together by gums, waxes and pectins. The tool amount of this material is up to 35%. So rating is not possible to extract the fiber. So the fiber can be extracted either by hand or decorated process by means of the machine. I will show you a video how the extraction has been carried out, okay, in case of rami fiber, because rating is not suitable. Why the rating is not suitable for the extraction of rami fiber? Because this fiber is connected together by gums, wax and pectins. It occupies 35% of its total composition. So the rating is not possible either by means of dew rating or stagnant water rating or running water rating or chemical rating. So the fiber has to be extracted either by means of hand or decorticated process, that is the machine which is used for extracting the fiber from the plant. Also the fibers can be separated chemically by boiling in an alkaline solution. So this boiling has been done by means of alkaline solution. So you have to add sodium hydroxide during this extraction process. I think you might be seen in the video in the last hemp fiber extraction. So how the separating has been taking place using sodium hydroxide solution by boiling with sodium hydroxide solution. So the fiber is separated. Okay, here also you have to either you can done by means of chemically or you can done either by means of hand or decorated process. Now look at see the properties and end use of this rami fiber. Rami fiber is oval in cross section with thick cell wall and fine lumen. What do you mean by lumen? It is an empty space present in your fiber. Okay. I think this lumen is present in almost all the cellulosic fibers, right from cotton to till your rami fiber. It is the longest of all the vegetable fibers. That is the main advantage of this rami fiber. Then coming to the strength, the wet strength of the fiber is high, and also the fiber dries very rapidly. So how much time it took? It took very, very little time for the drying process. So in general, the fiber is strong, stiff, and silky like structure, luster. So after the preparation of the fiber, if you look at the shining property, how it looks like silk. So silk is having natural luster. Luster is your shining property. So similar to the silk, your rami fiber also looks very good luster. Then coming to the end use of this rami fiber. The fiber is used for sailcloth, ropes, fish nets, upholstery fabrics, and for paper making machines. So these are all the end uses of your rami fiber. Just a minute.
Rami is one of the oldest textile fibers known to man, dating as far back as 5000 BC when it was used for making mummy cloth in Egypt. Rami has been grown in China for many centuries and farmers in ancient China are known to have used the fiber to weave clothing. In India, Rami cultivation is just as old, being grown in Assam and Meghalaya and used mostly in fishing nets and for making ropes, but never for commercial use. In Meghalaya, most of the Rami is produced at household level and as a means of sustenance. Rami fiber is difficult to process, requiring specialized machines and expensive process. So when synthetic fibers and cotton were introduced, the use of Rami considerably declined. As a result, many farmers from Meghalaya had to abandon Rami farming and move on to other means of livelihood. However, Rami possesses certain properties such as smooth luster, being absorbent and easy to wear, being naturally stain resistant, ability to keep its shape, and others that makes it an excellent fabric. And because of this, today its popularity is again rising. Rami has numerous of industrial and textile application, ranging from fishing nets, packaging, clothing, to the development of advanced ecological composite material used in cars. In Meghalaya, early attempt to commercialize the crop were initiated by the government of Meghalaya in the year 2015.
The government of Meghalaya, along with the Vision Program, thought it wise to, or rather, you know, thought it prudent to, you know, have a look at Rami once again because of its tremendous potential for commercialization as well as for bringing better incomes to farmers. It was only in 2017 that through the initiative of collaboration and the agreement to collaborate with the French embassy, and through his initiative as the resident commissioner at my house, he actually initiated this current initiative which is happening now, this is Bonjour India, which is a showcase event, actually an event for showcasing made
for employment and livelihood creation, especially in rural areas. Globally, there is a sizable market for Rami, and India is one of the major producers of Rami along with China, Brazil, Philippines, South Korea and Thailand.
So Rami has good potential. Big quantity of Rami fabrics, Rami made-ups are being imported from China, and it is sold all over the world. Popularity is growing, usage is growing, because it is natural, it is organic, it is low impact to the earth, it is eco-friendly, it is biodegradable. The global market is growing. See, natural textile has a market of $92 billion as of date, and it is predicted that by 2025, the natural textiles demand will grow up to $163 billion.
Interventions on the ground were first started in Garo Hills by the Department of Agriculture.
It was started to implement it from 2016 onwards. It's already 2 years. Already 2 years from the initial states. The objective of preparation of this project is for economic upliftment of the rural farmers. Really regenerate.
Position and it's very time and fabric. So we initiated contact with them, which we help out
through a process called stripping and ribboning. Thirdly, it is then placed inside a decortication machine and fiber is extracted. Fourth, the extracted fiber is then taken to be washed. Fifth, once washed, the fiber is kept for drying. And sixth, the dried fiber is ready for storage and transportation.
This crop is propagated vegetatively through rhizomes. And this one, once you grow this Rami crop, it will survive up to 10 to 15 years. And during the time
In Meghalaya, Rami has had significant impact, especially on rural farmers and weavers in the state. Today, there are about 300 farmers who are engaged in Rami farming, whose livelihoods are intertwined with this crop.